And even as India keeps a close watch at the Chinese provocation at the line of actual control, the threat of increasing in other domains too. Remember, India today has now learnt from top sources that there has been a 300% increase in cyber attacks from China post Galwan clash. What is alarming really is that the Chinese hackers are reportedly using People's Liberation Army infrastructure. Chinese hackers are targeting government agencies, Indian companies with global reputation as well. Initial targets were indigenous industry like media, mobiles, construction companies, and earlier these hackers operated from either Pakistan or North Korea. Now Indian intelligence agencies have learnt most of new cyber attacks are being launched from bases in Beijing, Guangzhou, Shenzhen and Chengdu.
The attack on our critical infrastructure, by destruction of our critical infrastructure, especially in the time of pandemic. Now, if you were to analyze sectors like telecom or power sector, we have huge dependencies of Chinese equipment.
The capacity of Chinese hackers is humongous. We have no idea what their level of hacking abilities are. In every university, there are committed hackers groups, which are all funded by the Chinese military, and they have been given specific tasks to hack our systems as and when it is.
And joining me now is Gaurav Sawant for further on this. Gaurav, this is definitely serious, because while there is the ground situation to take care of, the cyber attacks and hacking is clearly what the Chinese are well known for.
Pooja, after the stalemate at the line of actual control, and that is where the Chinese realized that they wouldn't be able to move forward, this is a cause for very grave concern, Chinese hacking attempts. Also the fact that now it's no longer happening through their vassal state Pakistan, or even through North Korea. From what we've been told now is that some of these hacking attempts have been traced right back to a Chinese very major military base, which is at Chengdu. It's also been traced back to Shanghai, Beijing and two other places within China. So this is a cause for concern that the Chinese People's Liberation Army, they have a section which only looks at cyber attacks, and they've done this. Remember, very recently Australia and the Prime Minister talked about the Chinese hacking attempts. The Chinese have in the past had attempted to hack the White House, the State Department, the US Department of Defense, and they're trying to hack systems in India, not just government systems, not just various other institutions, but also India's banking system. And that could be a cause for very grave concern, because attacking a banking system directly affects the people, yes, of our country, and could lead to trouble on ground. So this is something that India needs to beware and counter it the way in some ways it is. In some other ways, if India needs to improve our firewalls.
Also, Gaurav, this may likely spread a little bit of fear and panic. There are people already boycotting Chinese goods, but how should the government now proceed? Because there have been applications which are Chinese and on the government radar, but do you think the government will also have to step up a little more on this issue?
Oh, absolutely. What happened at Galwan, General V.K. Singh gave details about how India gave China a bloody nose at Galwan. We've lost 20 of our braves, but the Chinese lost more than 40 soldiers. That's been an eye-opener, but that's equally an eye-opener for government of India, for us to realize that whatever happened at, Wuhan or Mamallapuram, Chinese are no friends of ours. Chinese don't want to be friends with us. And the Chinese are very clearly trying to undermine India's rise as a global power. So China does not want India to be a global power. While we continue to rise, would we still want Chinese interference, whether it's in our radar system, whether it's in our railway system, whether it's in our electrification system? In all of this, the Chinese were given access. And why were they given access? That's one reason. And two, going forward, there is no way that the Chinese should have access to Indian telecommunication, because they could play havoc, having access to our telecommunication system, radar system, railway system, yes, or any such system, which, God forbid, should the balloon go up or should there be tension, they can hack into it and make life miserable for us.
Gaurav Sawant tracking the ground situation as well, and also the cyber attacks by the Chinese agencies. Time to really be for caution for India. Gaurav, thank you very much for all the latest.